The prophet Isaiah in Isaiah 46, chapter 46, declares in verse 3, they hear the word of the Lord. He says, listen to me, family of Jacob, everyone that's left of the family of Israel. I've been carrying you on my back from the day you were born, and I'll keep carrying you when you're old. I will be there bearing you when you're old and gray. I've done it and will keep going at it, carrying you on my back, saving you. This is the word of the Lord. The Bible says, the prophet Isaiah says that the Lord has spoken to Israel that I have been carrying you since you were born. I've been carrying you on my back and I will continue to do that. I just want to release a word over you this day. I just want to pray for you, declare and make a declaration that the Lord is carrying you in this season. It doesn't matter what you're going through, what is happening around you. I pray and I declare in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that the Spirit of the Lord is carrying you. Whatever you're going through, financial issues, economical issues, political crisis, I declare that the presence of God is carrying you in this season. I declare that you are not alone and you will never be alone, for His word declares that He will never leave you nor forsake you. He will be with you in the times of trouble because He is a present help in the time of trouble. And so I declare in this season, as you move forward, even as we're in this pandemic, that the Lord will carry you through financial situations, that the Lord will carry you through marital affairs, that the Lord will carry you through religious confusion in the church. Whatever is happening around you, the Lord will lift you up and He will carry you in His arms, because His arms are not short that He's not able to reach out to you. So I declare that even though your mother, your father has forsaken you, that friends have rejected you, that you may be forsaken and cast down, that nothing seems to be working out for you and everything you put your hands to, it is failing. Everything you attempt to do, it has fallen to the ground. You've been forsaken, rejected. You've been used and abused. You've lost some things. You've lost some people. It seems like there's no coming back in this season. You have nothing to bounce back on. You have no one to call on. You have no one to lean on to be a source of comfort. I declare in this season that God is your strength, that God is about to carry you into your place of wealth, into your place of growth and increase, that God is about to pull you out from where they have left you. I declare in this season that God is turning the tables around and that He will begin to perfect all things that concern you. Listen, whatever you're going through, God's about to snatch you right out of that broken place. God's about to snatch you out of that miry clay. He's about to snatch you out of that pit that they have dug for you, and He's about to plant your feet on higher ground. Listen, God's about to elevate you so high that your enemies will begin to look upon you. Those that overlooked you, you will come to a season where you are now being overbooked. God shall make your rejected voice a voice to the nation. God will cause your muzzled voice to become a voice of mighty revelation. God will use you, the stone that the builder have refused, the one that they looked down on, the one they scoffed on, the one they laughed at, they mocked, they ridiculed, they jeered. God's about to use your voice. God's about to use your temple to deliver the very same people that walked out on you. Let me tell you, the Bible speaks about on the account of a man named Joseph, where his brothers abandoned him, but the Bible said that God rose up Joseph and God blessed him with wealth. God blessed him in high, great positions, political, governmental positions. God gave him authority, jurisdictional authority. And so the very same people that walked out on him, that mocked him, that sold him out, they had to come and bow before him for help. Listen, don't count out your enemies just yet. Do not declare your enemies to die just yet. For David declares in Psalm 23 that your enemies, in the presence of my enemies, thou shalt prepare a table for me. And so I declare over your life that some of your enemies shall not die just yet. Some of your enemies will not be wiped out yet. Some of your enemies will not be put to shame just yet, that they will run and hide. But I declare that as God elevates you, that God increases you, that as God exceeds your imagination, as God lifts you up on high, I declare that your enemies will live to see. That's when your enemies will be put to shame. When God begins to bless you, your enemies will begin to regret. Your enemies will begin to repent. Your enemies will begin to retreat because of what they have spoken. They will be sorry because they will wish they never have fought against you. They will wish they never had spoken evil against you. I pray and I release the glory of God upon your life. And I'm here to let you know that this is not the end, but this is the beginning. This is the beginning of a turnaround. This is the beginning of a new season. This is the beginning of something great and mighty, because God's about to use you to do the unexpected. God's about to shift the entire trajectory of your life. Your emotional state is coming together. Your mental state is coming together. Your peace of mind is coming together. Your marriage is coming together. Your ministry is coming together. Your spirituality is coming together. God is pulling everything together and he's making you new again. He's making you whole again. He's making you strong once again. Come on, because you shall not die. You shall not surrender, but you shall live to declare the words of the Lord. This is the beginning and not the end. God shall perfect all things concerning you. You have already struggled, that's the end. You have already toiled and labored, that's the end. You have already cried yourself to sleep, and that is the end. Now this is your time to rejoice, because weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Watch God work for you. God is changing your garment of heaviness, that garment of shame, and God is putting glory upon your life. God is adding glory to your life. You will see the goodness of God. You will see the grace of God work for you in this season. Keep holding on to God. Keep trusting God. Keep putting in your faith in God, because he is able to do what he said he will do. He said he will never change his mind concerning you. He said, just as I have carried Israel from they were babies until they're old and gray, it is the same way that I will carry you. That's the word of the Lord. I will carry you until you're old and you're gray. For David said, I've been young and now I'm old, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken. You will not be forsaken, and you shall not die. But I declare and I release the grace of God over your life. You shall live. You shall live. And everything that concerns your life shall live in this season. The Lord bless you and be of good courage. Be of good courage. Wait on the Lord and trust in him. In Jesus' mighty name. My name is Pastor Shanique Beckford. I love you. The Lord loves you. Enjoy the rest of your day.